Hello students, welcome to Gyanvihar School of Education, Suresh Gyanvihar University. I'm Dr. Sonia Kaur Bansal, and today we will be discussing about affective ways of learning according to Bloom's taxonomy in the subject Psychology of Teaching and Learning. So students, my learning objective of today's class to just enable you in understanding what is the Bloom's taxonomy and what are the various parts of Bloom's taxonomy. And mainly we will focus on cognitive and affective and psychomotor basis of learning in this lecture. But the focus will be remaining on affective base of learning. So let's understand what is affective base of learning and how the affective base of learning is dealing with different terminology when we are going to teach in the classroom. And what kind of behavioral changes are expected from students after teaching a content. All right. So let's understand students affective base of learning according to Bloom's taxonomy. Before I explain you about affective base of learning, let me introduce you students about Benjamin S. Bloom. Benjamin S. Bloom, full name was Benjamin Samuel Bloom, and he was born on 21st February 1913, and he died in September 13, 1999 in Chicago. He was an American citizen and he was qualified in PhD in education. And by profession, he was an educational psychologist, students, and he was employed in American Educational Research Association. So this is a brief introduction of Bloom's taxonomy and how we are going to understand about it. So before looking at Bloom's affective base of learning, let's understand what is exactly the Bloom's taxonomy. So Bloom's taxonomy comprises of three learning domains: the cognitive, affective, and psychomotor. And assigns to each of these domains a hierarchy that corresponds to different level of learning. So I hope you are understanding that in earlier lecture, we have discussed about Bloom's taxonomy, that how it is actually developing from complex, simple to complex, and from lower level to higher level. So it is important for you to note that the different levels of thinking defined within each domain of taxonomy are hierarchical. Clear, students? So in other words, each level subsumes the level that comes before it. That means it is very much important for every teacher and every student to understand that if we are talking about the Bloom's taxonomy, then it is important to understand the lower levels first, and then it is going up and up. But before going to the next level, it is desirable from the students and teachers to learn the level which comes before it. Clear? So if we look at the cognitive domain, for example, which is represented in next figure, which I'm going to tell you, we can infer that before a student can conduct an analysis, they first might need to know what is exactly the method of analysis and understand the different elements to review that and consider which method to apply. Clear, students? So it is only then that they will be ready to conduct the analysis itself. Clear? So this is about a brief introduction of Bloom's taxonomy, and it is in continuation. I'm telling you the three main types of learning. So there is more than one type of learning. So a committee of colleges led by Benjamin S. Bloom, 1956, they identified three main important domains of educational activities. They said that any activities happens in the classroom or outside the classroom, they can be classified into three main categories. And these three categories will lead to a good behavioral changes in the students. So these are basically related to cognitive, affective, and psychomotor. Cognitive domain relates to mental skills, where we are talking about knowledge, reasoning, analysis, synthesis, evaluation. We had discussed in detail in elaboration in earlier lecture, and now we are going to discuss about affective in this lecture. So affective is dealing with growth in feelings or emotional areas or attitude. See students, it is very important for everyone to understand that how the attitude is developed. It is because of emotional areas and feelings which a person is feeling about someone or something. So this affective domain definitely has to be developed by the teacher, because if, for example, the teacher is teaching a patriotic song, and if the students are not feeling that patriotism inside them, so how will it be useful? No, it will not be useful. So that is the importance of affective domain in teaching and learning process. Then we are going to discuss about psychomotor. Psychomotor domain of learning, students, relates to H hands, which I have already told you. So manual or physical skills, and it is skill-based domain, which requires from a learner to be very well versed with the physical activities and other motor activities. So these are the three types of learning according to Bloom's taxonomy. So just remember them for a better learning. Now, we all know that Bloom's taxonomy provides an excellent structure for planning, designing, assessing, and evaluating training and learning effectiveness. The model also serves as a sort of checklist as which you can assure and ensure that training plan to deliver all the necessary development for students, trainees, or learners. And a template by which you can assess the validity and coverage of any existing training, be it a course or a curriculum or an entire training and development program for a large organization. Clear, students? So this is how Bloom's taxonomy is very important in its own form. Now, it is fascinating that Bloom's taxonomy model of 1956 and 64. So, and Kilpatrick's learning evaluation model, which came in 1959, remain classical reference models and tools into the 21st century. And this is because concepts such as Bloom's taxonomy, Kilpatrick's model, Maslow's hierarchy of needs, MacGregor's XY theory, the Swartz analysis model, and Bernays' transactional analysis theory, to name a few other examples, are timeless. They're not set in one time. They are for forever. They have created such beautiful principles that they are actually relevant in all the eras, all the time. So such will always be relevant to the understanding and development of people and organization, what they actually believe and what they expect from the learners to behave. So this is how it's really very interesting that although the Bloom's taxonomy is really very old, and revised form also came in 2001, but now here we are talking about in this 21st century, still it is really very relevant. Clear, students? Now let's understand that Bloom's taxonomy model is in three parts or overlapping domains. Again, Bloom used rather academic language, but the meanings are simple to understand. So cognitive domain, intellectual capabilities and knowledge, it is related to that. Affective domain is dealing mainly with feelings, emotions and behavior. So this is how Bloom's taxonomy is really very important. So to understand it in a more effective way, we are going to discuss a lot about it. So psychomotor domain, manual or physical skills, or do. So this has given rise to the obvious shorthand variations on the theme, which summarize the three domains. For example, skill, knowledge, and attitude. We call it in short KS, KAS, do, think, and feel. So etc. we can define in that way. So cognitive, affective and psychomotor domain are really very important if you want to understand Bloom's taxonomy. Clear, students? So now in each of the three domains, it is really very important to understand that these three domains of Bloom's taxonomy are based on the premise that the categories are ordered in degree of difficulty. So each and every categories are ordered in such a way. An important premise of Bloom's taxonomy is that each category or level must be mastered before progressing to the next. As such, the categories within each domain are levels of learning development, and these levels increase in difficulty. So this is how Bloom's taxonomy is working in that beautiful way, that if you are learning something, you have to go to the lower level first and then up and up in other way. Now the simple matrix structure enables a checklist or template to be constructed for the design of learning programs, training courses, lesson plans, etc. So effective learning, especially in organization where training is to be converted into organizational results, should arguably cover all the levels of each of the domains where relevant to the situation and the learner. So the learner should benefit from development of knowledge and intellect, cognitive domain, attitude and belief, active affective domain, and the ability to put physical and bodily skills into effect to act psychomotor domain. So this is how it is really very defined in a beautiful way, that benefits of the development of knowledge and intellect is considered into cognitive domain. This is really very required. When as a teacher, I'm going to teach in my class to my students, I really want them to develop intellectually. And I really want them to develop that attitude which is required for a particular chapter or a content which I'm teaching today, tomorrow, or anytime. So I want to create that belief among the students that whatever we have learned is right or wrong, or they must develop that attitude. So this will work in affective domain. And then theoretical is nothing. Practical is also needed. So theoretically, when the child is sound enough and is learning enough, but there is no knowledge of practical part, so it will lack in psychomotor domain, and this has to be developed in skill wise also. So to act, to behave, and to apply the knowledge in practical form, that comes in psychomotor domain. All right, students. So now this is how a matrix structure is. Very good structure is given by Bloom, and this is how the learning programs, training courses and lesson plans is formulated, and it is delivered in the classrooms. So it is really very worthy to understand that when we are at the lower level, so lower level goes to the higher and higher, and the students are learning in that way only. So simple to complex proceedings are here in Bloom's taxonomy. Now let's understand in detail about affective domain. Yes, affective, which is affecting us. It means feeling, emotions, attitude, and feel. We are feeling about something. We are having emotions, and emotions. Emotion is a word. It's a beautiful word, students, that has come from Latin word immover. And it means to stir up. And what to stir up? To stir up our feelings and what we have inside. For example, if I'm feeling anger, so I'm expressing it through my behavior. That is emotion. So how affective domain is working in teaching and learning process, that is very, very important. And then attitude. And then feel. So this is how, students, we are actually understanding that affective domain is that part where we are developing the child in a very good form in cognitive part, and intellectually we are making him sound, reasonable, logical. And in psychomotor part, we are combining theoretical plus practical part, where the child is using all the learned theoretical concepts into the practical form. And the child is really believing that now he or she can do that particular work in skill form also. But to feel, to do the work and to just connect emotions with that work is related to affective domain. So let's understand in a detailed manner. So now Bloom's taxonomy, second domain, the affective domain, was detailed by Bloom, Carthwohl, Marcia in 1964, students, in the book Taxonomy of Educational Objectives, volume 2, the affective domain. Bloom, Carthwohl, and Marcia. Bloom's theory advocates the structure and sequence for developing attitude, also now commonly expressed in the modern field of personal development as belief. Again, as with the other domains, the affective domain detail provides a framework for teaching, training, assessing, and evaluating the effectiveness of training and lesson design and delivery, and also the retention by and effect upon the learner of the trainee. So it's really very important to understand that Bloom's taxonomy in affective domain favors the structure and sequence of developing the attitude, also now commonly expressed in the modern field of personal development as beliefs. So although the issues around emotions and learning are not new, the term affective learning has only recently been defined as the learning that relates to the learner's interest, attitudes, and motivations. Clear, students? So in the digital age we live through, affective learning is destined to be technological driven or at least enhanced. So having overemphasized cognitive and relatively neglecting the affective dimension in the past, technology enhanced learning is now enforced by new neuroscience findings, and it has confirmed that affect is complexly intertwined with thinking and performing important functions that may guide rational behavior, assist memory retrieval, support decision making, and enhance creativity as well. Okay, students, so now the affective domain focuses on the attitudes, values, interest, and appreciation of the learners. It is overall developing the feelings of whatever the content you are teaching. So the hierarchy of affective domain is associated with it, begin with receiving and listening to information, and extends to characterization or internalizing values and consistently acting upon them. So these are the hierarchy which we are following in affective domain. Now understand, students, that it moreover focuses on allowing learners to understand what their own values are and how they have developed them gradually. Okay, students, so it's really very important to understand for all of you that whatever the content you will be teaching in your classroom, that has to be clear, that has to be really very well in coordination. So this is how affective domain is working well with teachers and students. If the students are working in that way, then the really teachers are also actually defining is that way. So students, understand that affective domain is really very important. And if the students are not actually understanding the affective domain, then whatever you have developed in cognitive domain as is in your psychomotor domain, it will be little useless. So clear, students? So understand that it is really very important, and it is really very significant from the point of view of teachers understanding and as well as the students understanding. Now let's understand, students, that affective domain is an emotional aspect of educational objectives, and it pertains to change in interest, what the student is having till now and what the student is supposed to have further after studying the content. The student is supposed to change his attitude. Maybe it is critically, maybe it is positive, maybe it is negative. And the student is also supposed to change his values related to content, concept the teacher is teaching in the class. It is moreover development of appreciation and adequate adjustment. So close relationship with cognitive and behavioral changes is related with affective domain. So each affective behavior has a corresponding cognitive behavior. And it's really very important for everyone to understand that affective domain is an emotional aspect of educational objectives, and it is really changes to pertain in situations. So this is how change in interest, change in attitude, change in values is really important when we are talking about affective domain. Feeling towards the concept, feeling what the teacher is teaching, that's really very important. So this is how I'm going to explain each and every criteria and hierarchy of the affective domain to you in today's class. Okay, students, so let's understand it in a more interpreted way. So affective domain is actually describe the way people react emotionally and their ability to feel another living thing's pain or joy. So typically target the awareness and growth in attitudes, emotions, and feelings. So whatever the development the teacher has done in a cognitive process or psychomotor process, it will be well coordinated with affective process also. The teacher is actually developing the attitudes, emotions in that way. So this is how the affective domain is really very important. And now let's understand the five levels of affective domain. They are receiving, responding, valuing, organizing, and characterizing. So these are the five levels, students, that anybody can understand in a very good way. So five levels are actually set from lower to higher. So it's really very important when you have to respond, first you have to receive something. And when you have to value, you have to give response to that. So it goes like that. So organizing will come only when you are receiving, responding, and valuing. And characterizing will come only if you have organized the concept in a very good way. So these are the five levels. We are going to study them in detail. First of all, receiving. What is receiving? Receiving is something to take. And in this part, students passively pays attention. Without this level, no learning can occur. Learner shows sensitivity to certain stimuli. And it is like the teacher catching the student's attention at that time. So student is here paying attention whatever the teacher is teaching. And without this level, and if the student is having no attention in the classroom, you cannot imagine that students are learning well and they are prepared for learning. So attention level comes at the first time. So the learner shows sensitivity. Okay, I'm interested in studying whatever the teacher is teaching. So the learner shows that the teacher is teaching something which is really useful for me and which is really interesting in somehow pattern. So receiving is leading to sample learning outcome. Listen to other students with respect. Sample assessments activity. Be an audience member to another student's presentation and then write a summary. Rational. Through this assignment, learner will learn how to listen effectively to others as well as remember key details about their presentation used in writing the summary. All right, students. So this is how receiving part is done when we are doing listening to other students with respect. Be an audience member. So first, attention level is discussed here. In another student's presentation, when there is something, then also the rest of the students are listening. So they are receiving something. So the justification behind this, that through this assignment, learners will learn how to listen effectively in the classroom, how to listen to others as well as remember key details about their presentations. So this is how it is developed. Now responding. So the students actively participate in the learning process, and responding expects greater motivation and regularity in attention. When the student is attentively listening to the teacher and paying close attention to whatever is being said, then it is definitely required from student part that now he or she is going to respond also. So great internal external motivation is required in this process. So described as interest, which means as a tendency to respond to a particular object or stimuli. Now you just remember the lower classes where the teacher asks a question and the students are really very happy to answer them, and they just raise their hands, ma'am, I'm going to tell. So this is the kind of motivation that is maintained by the students themselves through internal motivation and by the teacher as well by maintaining the external motivation. So this is how responding becomes very important and a very significant part of affective domain. Clear, students? So now understand that responding is sample learning outcome. If we are talking about speak effectively in front of an audience, you are responding to the answers and actively responding to the others. So this is how it is being developed. So sample assessment activity, present on a subject in front of the class and answer questions from peers about their presentations. So this is how assessment and activity is also important in responding process. So it's vice versa, how we are going to entertain it. Now rational. So through this, learners will become more comfortable with public speaking as well as more comfortable with contributing to a discussion in the form of answering questions. So this is how responding is done. Now valuing. So the students attaches a values to an object. Whatever the child is listening in the receiving part of the affective domain, and after listening very carefully with full motivation, which is also described as interest in affective domain, when the child is responding, now the child is actually, or the student is attaching a value to an object or the phenomena or the piece of information that he has got from his teacher or the environment. So acceptance of a value, preference of a value, commitment is really required. So the motivation of behavior, not by deliberate desire, but by the individual's commitment to the underlying value guiding the behavior. So it is also called attitude. The objectives are prime shift control from which the conscience of the individual is developed into control behavior. All right, students. So this is called valuing. Now, in valuing, when we discussed about sample learning outcomes, so it is demonstrating and explain how values regarding various topic is related. So sample assessment, writing an opinion piece of any issue, explaining one's own stance and reasons supporting that stance. So rational is through this, learners will explore not only their own rule values, but they also support their values. So giving them a chance to understand more fully their own value system. So this is how students are actually learning the value system. So students understand that this is how something is actually important at the valuing part. And justification is very clear that learners are exploring not only to own their own values, but they also support their values which they already possess. And they're giving them chance to understand more fully their own value system. Now this comes the organizing part. So the organizing part, the students can put together different values, information, ideas, and accommodate them within his her own schema, comparing, relating, and elaborating on what has been learned. So conceptualization of a value, organization of a value system is really needed. Organization connotes a system of values or attitudes, development of one's own code of conduct, and public life may be an instance of an organization of value system. So this is really very important from the point of view of students that they must organize, they must put together the different ideas and different values what they have learned. So it is really very understanding from the part of their own self that they are creating their own schema for comparing, for relating, for elaborating what they have learned just now. All right, student. So it is really very important on that part also. So this is how something is done in that way, that the students are actually creating their own way of understanding and organizing. So this is how actually the organizing part. So now the students are actually organization. When we are talking about sample and outcome, compare value system and then compare the value systems and valued. So this is actually organizing and comparing different differences between them and why the differences have arisen. So rational is about in doing this activity and doing this, the learners put into the place organized as well as they are supporting different value system across the world. Now let's understand about characterizing students. So the last of the categories that we are understanding here in affective domain given by Bloom's taxonomy is reached when an individual is consistently found behaving in accordance with the values or attitudes or he has embedded. So this is how I'm actually clearing this very much point of view that you are not only creating the philosophy of his own life. So this is also very important, an internal compulsion to pursue it. Okay, students. So now you are very much understanding that what is the characterizing. Now, characterization, sample learning, outcome work well in a team of peers. So this is how you are going to understand team of peers and rational by working in a group. Learners and must balance their own values with the values of team as well as prioritize task and practice teamwork. So let's understand students in a more effective way that how the affective domain is working on different categories of level and how the behavior is expected. So examples of experience or demonstration or evidence to be measured here, we are going to discuss, and then keywords describes which describe the activity to be trained and measure at each level. So first of all, receiving that we have discussed and open to experience, willing to hear. So behavioral expression is here that we are open to experience and then listen to teacher, to trainer, to take interest in session or learning experience, take notes. So turn them up. So this is how learning experience, practice, participate passively. ask, listen, focus, attend, take part, discuss, knowledge, share, be open to retain, follow, concentrate, read to feel. So this is how it is very important for everyone. All right. Then comes for responding. So responding, when we're talking about behavioral description, it is dealing with reactions and participation in a very active form. And the examples of that are related to. So examples which I'm relating. So it is relating to participation actively in group discussion, active participation, in actively interest, in outcome, enthusiasm for action, question and probe, ideas, suggest, interpretation. So react, respond, seek clarification and clarify, provide other references and examples, contribute, questions, present sight, become animated or excited, help team, write and perform. So these are all related to affective domain while we are talking about responding. Okay, students. So now here we come to the next thing, that is value. Value means attaching values and expressing personal opinions in this part and deciding the worth and relevance of ideas, experiences, accept or commit to particular stance or action. So this is how argue, challenge, debate, refute, confront, justify, persuade, criticize, all these terminology is set for value system. Then organize or conceptualize values. So reconcile internal conflicts, develop value system, qualify and quantify personal views, state personal positions and reasons, state beliefs, and then build, develops, formulate, defend, modify, relate, prioritize, reconcile, contrast, arrange and compare. So next is internalize or characterize. So this is how we are going to understand that it is relating to the behavioral term, that is adopting belief system and system and self-reliant. So behave consistently in that way, behave consistently with the self personal value set. So this is how students are actually understanding how everything is set. Now let's understand, students, that there are three domains of Bloom's taxonomy and we are going to understand the MCQs about it. I hope you will really do well and you will understand the Bloom's taxonomy in a very effective way. So the three domains of Bloom's taxonomy are cognitive, affective and psychomotor. B, cognitive, pedagogy and psychomotor. Cognitive, affective and pedagogy. Cognitive, affective and psychomotor. So the correct answer is cognitive, affective and psychomotor. So this is the correct answer of Bloom's taxonomy and we have discussed it in detail that how cognitive, affective and psychomotor affects the person's learning process. Next question, the philosopher who worked in mathematical and scientific didactic was Jean Piaget, John Dewey, Martin Wagenshin, Lev Vygotsky. So what is actually describing here? So understand, students, that answer C, Martin Wagenshin, is the correct answer. He worked in mathematical and scientific didactic. Now next is, according to Plato, the highest goal in all of education is knowledge of the science, mathematics, philosophy, goodwill. So the correct answer is goodwill. And according to Plato, the highest goal in all of education is of the knowledge is related to goodwill of any person or anything. The next question, an assessment that is generally carried out throughout a course is called diagnostic assessment, formative assessment, summative assessment, contemporary assessment. So the correct answer is formative assessment. Clear, students? Now, next question is the use of physical punishment for class management is called extinction technique, satiation technique, timeout technique, corporal punishment. So the correct answer is corporal punishment. Now understand, students, next question. According to John Locke, a child's mind goes, mind does not contain any innate ideas, B, memory, C, observation, and D, imagination. So the correct answer is innate ideas. And according to John Locke, a child's mind does not contain any innate ideas. Now, these are some references, students, for your more study purpose. And I really believe that you will understand them and you will revise the topic and you will enhance your learning. All right, student. So students, in today's class, we have learned a lot and we have understood what is actually about Benjamin S. Bloom. We have understood that Benjamin S. Bloom was a person who worked very dedicatedly in the field of educational psychology. He was PhD in education, so he worked so hard in developing this Bloom's taxonomy. And when we have discussed about Bloom's taxonomy, we came to know about that Bloom's taxonomy comprises three learning domains: the cognitive, affective, and psychomotor, and assigns to each of these domains a hierarchy that corresponds to different levels of learning. So I really believe, students, that you will understand that how it is really very important for any prospective teacher as well as any good teacher to understand about it. So just understand that, students, that when we are talking about, when we are actually learning something, so we must not actually think in that way that what students are doing. But we must think in that way that what the students are actually learning in their cognitive form, affective form, or psychomotor form. Dear students, so we have discussed the various levels, which were five levels I have discussed with you, which were like receiving, responding, and valuing, organizing, characterizing. So this is how the important five levels we have discussed. And then we discussed about receiving, that receiving is the first level and it is closely dealing with students' attention. And without this level, no learning can occur. And the learner shows sensitivity to certain stimuli. And it is like the teacher catching the student's attention. So this is how receiving is really very important when the teacher is starting teaching. Then we discussed about responding, and I told you, students, that responding is something which is related to internal and external kind of motivation of the students. So in this part, the student actively participates in the learning process, and responding expects greater motivation and regularity in attention. And it is also described as interest, which means a tendency to respond to a particular object or a stimuli. Then we discussed about valuing. So the student attaches a value to an object, phenomena, or piece of information. So acceptance of value, preference of value, commitment, the motivation of behavior, not by deliberate desire, but by the individual's commitment to the underlying. And value guiding the behavior. So this is called attitude, that what the student has actually developed. Clear, students? Then the objectives are prime shift from which the conscience of the individual is development into the control behavior. Then we discussed about organizing. It means that putting up all the ideas together, whatever it is learned in the classroom situation, and developing the schema here. Then we also discussed about characterizing in the five levels. That is the topmost level, characterizing. And this is the last of the categories reached when an individual is consistently found behaving in accordance with the values or attitudes. So he consistent philosophy of life, his own and internal compulsion to pursue it, and how the student is going to pursue that. Clear, students? So this is how it is really very important for everyone. So this now this is all about affective domain of Bloom's taxonomy, students. I really believe that all of you have learned the affective domain in a very good way. So I believe that when you, as a prospective teacher, you learn about Bloom's taxonomy, and specifically its three domains, cognitive, affective, and psychomotor. So you cannot actually take the teaching profession for granted, because you know that there are various categories which are classified by Bloom's taxonomy, and students are going to learn in that way. All right, students. So students, see you in the next class with psychomotor domain. Until then, stay safe, stay happy, and keep learning. Thank you, students.